You know, if you want to get the Russian bots excited on your YouTube channel, you make a video about the Su-57, and I did that last week. And guess what? We're going to make another one, because someone sent a link to another angle of the Su-57 flying at Zhuhai, or the T-50, that's the prototype of the Su-57. And we're going to talk about that, because I think there were some valid points, and it's worthy of taking another look. Ultimately, this is a really maneuverable fighter. We're not comparing the beeps and squeak, which really is the bread and butter of a fifth generation fighter, but that's all classified stuff. We're looking at the maneuverability. We're going to compare that. So let's jump into it. So here we go. This is the takeoff roll. This is Sergey Bogdan. I'm probably butchering that. I don't speak Russian, but I had the honor of meeting him in 2017 at the Dubai Airshow when they were showcasing the Su-35, which was an impressive demo. Like any fighter air show, the takeoff, you want that thing to be impressive. You're showing just how maneuverable, how powerful that thing is, you know, right after, you know, low to the ground, right after getting off, getting airborne. And that's what I think it does. What I'm watching here is the nose position and the nose authority and the low speed regime. And so, yeah, he's able to go into basically a half loop, roll out, get the nose tracking in a, you know, relatively energy deficient state. The roll rate here we talked about last video, you know, is on par with any fourth generation or fifth generation fighter. I think that's more or less pilot limited, because it gets pretty disorienting the faster you roll. But right here, seeing that nose whip around, being able to control that nose in a low speed, low energy state is what's impressive. That's really what we're talking about and makes or breaks a fighter when it comes to close in dogfighting, you know, basic fighter moving, et cetera, the ability to get the nose around in low speed regime. So in theory, we've skipped all the beyond visual range stuff. You've met another fighter such as a Su-57 at the merge. He who can point and get into a weapons engagement zone the fastest is the winner. And the loser, unfortunately, gets to go home in a different ride, not where you want to be. Being able to get the nose around and get into a weapons engagement zone is the impressive part here. So he's obviously able to do that. You can reference the clouds there. There's not a lot of forward movement across the ground, so he slowed that ground speed. Would a Russian fighter pilot execute this maneuver in a dogfight? I don't know. Really, they're showcasing the maneuverability here. So in some form or fashion, being able to get the nose and to threaten your adversary is what they would most likely be doing in this case. You know, ultimately, you're going to have to power out of this. So he is a falling leaf. You get one shot at this point, right? But no matter how powerful your motors are, et cetera, like now you have to drive and get out of this if you're still in a dogfight and your adversary is still alive. Thrust vectoring, again, tough for me to see in this resolution, but you can kind of notice the cans moving a little bit. The T-50, the Su-57 has thrust vectoring. Big old flight control surfaces allowing it to be this maneuverable in low speed regimes. Someone did make a comment about, oh, this would be a great maneuver to dodge like a surface-to-air missile or a long-range missile shot. I say good luck. I want you to dodge a wrench that's going Mach 4 as you're pulling G's looking over your shoulder. If you can do that, you are a champion, and I wish you the best of luck. I don't see a whole lot of practicality of like timing this just right to execute, you know, a Cobra maneuver to dodge a missile. I've shot AIM-120s, and you can see it for about a half a second, and then it's gone, right? So now imagine picking up, you know, a needle on the horizon that's going Mach 4 and trying to dodge that. I don't think I would be able to do it. Maybe you can do it. So I wish you the best of luck when it comes to that. Yeah, so now powering through. It does look like he's able to accelerate fairly quickly. Two motors, I imagine they're big old motors, as he's climbing up into the bososphere. So right there, again, I'm observing the, you know, how fast you see that plane form of the jet. The nose is coming around pretty quickly. Even if he is fast, that is still pretty quick as he's come through and done a pretty tight loop up at the top into a pedal turn or whatever the Russians might call it. Again, here he is able to point wherever he wants across the turn circle, but he is a falling leaf. So, you know, if you don't get your shots across or you miss that, you still have to power out of it. But you only have to do it once. You only have to get your nose inside a weapons engagement zone once. I mean, we're negating all high off boresight weapons. Just talk about nose position here. I did mention the motors being a little smoky. Someone made a comment they don't think that's a big deal. You know, I would agree to a certain extent. Like, would you be able to pick that up with a naked eyeball at 20 miles? No. But, you know, anything, any visual signature you're putting out, it's not a good thing, but it's probably not that big of a deal. I'll see if we could see some thrust vectoring. I know it's happening there. Last video, you definitely could see the tails moving, which I thought was interesting. I didn't realize the entire tails move, which definitely gives it some low speed maneuverability advantage over a lot versus like the rudder, which is usually just the back part of the tail, back portion of the tail. These guys look like they had an epic spot to film this. I'm sure their ears are just ringing. All right, if we can't see it here, we'll never see it. Again, cashing in a lot of energy, getting that nose around, tight turn. That is impressive. So the little Cobra maneuver. So into the vertical, rolled out, and then stop. That's creating a lot of geometry problems if you're a defensive fighter. So you know, would you execute that maneuver? I don't know, but if you were defensive and you needed to create some, you know, closure problems for your adversary, that absolutely would do it. Mid-range weapons, spit them out front, whatever you want to do there. That's going to be difficult to reposition if you're an offensive fighter and not get out in front. Again, assuming we got to the merge. Able to carve a lot of angles, low speed regime, yet again. It would be cool to see the footprint of how, if he stayed inside the airport footprint. You know, as an airshow pilot, that's one thing I always try to do is stay as tight and close to the crowd as humanly possible. That way it's not too boring for the airshow. You know, if you're able to do pedal turns and J turns all day long, you definitely should be able to stay pretty close to the airshow environment. So here, basically bringing the ground speed to nil. Again, just showcasing high angle of attack, slow speed maneuverability, and he is just slowly walking down the crowd line there. Dumps the nose. Let's see where this goes. I imagine some crazy maneuver. Accelerate out. Wouldn't you know it? So low energy states, able to whip the nose around 180 degrees back into the fight. So, and if you were a spectator there, I'd imagine the Su-57 stayed in front of you the entire time. Yeah, these guys got a great shot of the air show. Lots of jet noise for sure. This looks like a high-speed pass. Yeah, no, I would say min-radius turn. Tough to tell how tight that is, but it does look fairly tight. And, of course, why not into the vertical? That's one thing I always try to showcase, was just the maneuverability after doing a 9G turn. And it looks like he is just continuing through into a vertical min-radius turn or a loop, which is impressive. F-16, we would just power and climb straight up. So a horizontal vertical min radius turn to a vertical min radius turn. Slow speed maneuverability. That's where you want to be if you're in a dogfight. The ability to do that. At times. There's trade-offs with everything, but he stayed slow, low energy, and very maneuverable. I think that's the downwind entry to land. We did watch the landing last time. This would be an interesting angle. I thought tight landing. Fighter, you don't want to have a big bomber pattern, and he definitely did not have that. But obviously, these people are in between downwind and the runway. RFAA probably losing their minds with the photo group here, but, you know. Yeah, that's like, it's a great final turn, rolling out right on the numbers. Nice touchdown. Well, there you go. That's another angle of the Su-57 flying at Zhuhai last week. Again, I thought it was a pretty maneuverable demonstration. Like, it's an impressive demonstration. You know, people can get all upset and spun up about it, but, you know, we can't really compare apples to apples. Hopefully never do that. No one wins in that case, but in my opinion, the Su-57 or the T-50 demo, rather, at Zhuhai was pretty impressive. So let me know what you want to do next. See you next time.